dripping goggles, drove the man to the grave, with the wind for a whirl, with the Neanderthal world, and that's how he raised the grave. Right, I'm going to do a very quick review. Well, I'm going to do three very quick reviews. I've done them as a threesome, three in a bed. So keep a lookout for that. You know, I don't know if I'll put a link in or whatever, I'll put something in. But keep a lookout for that. Probably put a link in the comments bit down there. Get on with it. I'm going to do the Henry Westons Vintage Perry. On the nose, it smelt like, well, I've got to smell it again. It's worn down a tiny little bit now while it's been sitting here for a while. But it smells on the nose, the one that I've got anyway, smell like dog turd. The kind of sulfites have gone mental. And it smells like rotten eggs, really smells horrible. But the taste is well, I'm going to taste it now. Hold on. A little clue when you're tasting this one. Usually I go like that because I always advocate getting a big breath in inside the glass just as you're tasting, just before you get it to your lips, so that you fill up the whole olfactory system as you're drinking in. But with this, do the opposite. Breathe out through your nose and then sip in at the same time. You don't want to smell it. Don't keep me in your mouth for too long, because then aromas might go up your nose. It smells of turd, but it's nice and zingy on the tongue. It's bittersweet, just enough bitterness in there, just enough tannins and that to balance it out beautifully. It is floral, it is lovely. It's just a really gorgeous, gorgeous perry. Lovely, lovely perry that is. Absolutely beautiful. Made from the Henry Westons. Absolutely beautiful. 7.5% ABV. But stinks. It stinks. Bloody horrible it stinks. So, you know, if you've got no sense of smell, you'll love it. But when I opened the bottle, it smelled lovely. Psst, it went, whoa, All right. But it stinks. It really is. It's bloody horrible. So, that's that one. Cheers. Bottoms up. Chin chin. See you soon.